It is match day, 9:30, as you can probably see behind me. It's 2 weeks since the anticlimax that was Yeovil at home in front of that record-breaking crowd at Med Lane, but we couldn't break Yeovil down. Scunthorpe today then, Jake and Jordan are travelling with me. Jake is actually driving for this one, so it's his turn for an away day. I'd be incredibly disappointed if we didn't win this one. You know, they're 5 losses on the spin. Yes, they've had some good news in the last 48 hours regarding like funding into the club. But if, and I said it on the paper suspective Thursday, if we don't win games like this, we don't deserve to go up, because Wrexham went there and got a 3-1 win. They've lost to some pretty poor teams as well that we've, you know, batted aside fairly easily. So I'll be getting picked up in a second. I'll see what the lads think, because obviously we've had nothing for 2 weeks. See what their take is on that Yeovil game and a lot of the rumours, you know, surrounding Langstaff and Bostock joining us. So it should be a good one. I'm really hoping we get the victory. Hour and a half there maybe, and then we'll check in when we get to the ground as well.
Run away, you can see Jordan's in the back. I'm going to get his thoughts a little bit later. Same with Jake, who's driving. You know, we've got to calm down a little bit here. 19 minutes late for pickup because Jake thought 36 miles would be enough to get us to Scunthorpe and back. So we're going to have to calm down a little bit, but we are on the way. Jake's clock says 10 past 11. It's 10 past 10, so not a great start from him, but, you know, we're almost out of Nottingham, so we'll take it. We'll catch up with Jordan. We're about 10 minutes away now from Scunthorpe. Made good time. Jake's done well with the drive. It's a must win. We can't lose, surely.
Yeah, I don't think we can't lose. I mean, after the Yeovil draw, I think we need to come back and get some momentum going again. I think that's the main thing that we need to do.
Who's going to play in that right wing back spot?
I think the main will come back in. I'm happy to just see them both rotate. When they're both just as good as each other. Both offer pretty similar stuff, really. So yeah, I'm happy for him to rotate whenever. I don't really mind who's playing, but I think the main will play today.
Sun's quite bright, as you can see. You probably can't see Jordan drifting into the back. Score prediction then, quick one.
Well, because of the troubles that Scunthorpe are having, maybe the morale's down, I'm going to go 4-1 knots.
I'm gonna end this one, catch up Jake in a bit before I go blind. I've got the driver here. Good drive, to be fair. Easy drive, wasn't it?
Yeah, nice drive.
We've seen the lineup. Jim O'Brien straight in. I would have thought he'd been too soft.
I'm so surprised by Jim O'Brien. Like, I didn't even, there was no, I didn't listen to Oleg Williams pre-match, but I didn't think there was any inkling of him even coming back, was there?
And Castro straight in. I mean, if I'm right, the last time Castro started away, he scored that free kick.
Yep.
I'm really surprised by the lineup. Toby in, if I'm correct, there's no Aaron Nemani on the bench.
So he must be injured still or something like that.
Do you know what? It tells me that Luke Williams is a manager that goes off what he sees in training as well, which I like. Confident?
You want a score prediction?
It's going to be 0-0, isn't it?
Yeah,
0-0.
Let's see. I was right last week.
Yeah, but you've said 0-0 every week, so
it's going to be 0-0 again.
Don't really count. Good round of applause for the Notts fans. Sold out away in here, which is really good. Aaron Neman is here, so that rules out, well, I assume it rules out injury. I'm possibly thinking maybe Luke Williams is still not happy how he defended against Southend, because ever since then, if I'm right, he's been dropped for Toby. So, interesting one there. Sort of gives me the sense that, you know, you really have to play for your place in this Notts team, which is really good. And also, Luke Williams has been talking about how good training's been. So maybe he's also looking at who's performed well in training over the last 2 weeks, because I know the intensity has been really good in those training sessions. So about 10 minutes till kick-off. Really, really looking forward to this. As I say, sold out away, and let's hope for a win. properly, it's very easy for us to get in down the side. So we had our runner put through for a cross. Again, we like to cross it low, hit a little bit too hard so no one can get on the end of it, but we recycled it and nearly had another chance. That was really, really easy. Scunthorpe then tried to break but couldn't quite get the pass. So 2 minutes gone, decent start from Knox.
Really good from Ruben. Nutmeg Savoy taking the corner short.
Ooh, it's been cleared by Scunthorpe, but that was so easy for Knox to get down the side again. Toby doesn't clear up, and Scunthorpe coming forward here. We've gone from attacking and winning a corner to a Scunthorpe attack. Opportunity plays over, but again, so easy for Knox to get forward and create. Less than 10 minutes in, Ruben's had another chance, just dragged it wide. We are all over Scunthorpe. They're trying to break, but they can't really get out of their own half. I'd love to see us get an early goal, but so far we're looking insanely comfortable and it's looking fairly easy to break through. An effort from Brindley, looked like it was going top corner, it's good, wasn't it?
Yeah, just whisked to the right a bit too much, but yeah, it looked like it was going to go in for a minute.
Yeah, we are all over Scunthorpe, just need that first goal. All Knots, don't take our chances, and Lavery scored for them, I think. First attempt they've had all game. We backed off, it's our own fault. We backed off, we let him come forward. Knots fans were shouting to go and engage with him, but they didn't, and he's put it to Stoke's near post. Should he have saved it? I don't know. I think it was a bit close in. Should have saved it? Not really sure, but we're 1-0 down. And now we know what happens, teams just sit in. To start, and he's proved why he should have been in there. It's a good finish. Again, Ruben makes it. He's been really, really good. And then, I wouldn't even say deservedly on turns, because we should be in the lead. We'll keep going. Knott's corner coming as half hour mark. I think Ruben's going to swing this in. He does. Castro goes to meet it, but we've still got the ball. Kyle Cameron's going to keep it alive. Turns towards the edge of the box. Gives it back to Brindley halfway. Campton, Scunthorpe. We've still got it, passing it around the edge of the box. May have lost the opportunity to do anything. But possession wise, we're still on it like we are every week. Brindley forward to Jim O'Brien. Inside to Castro, really good work. Free kick on the edge of the box for Knox. Really good shooting opportunity. I'll check back in the sec. Set the wall, Castro over it, Ruben over it. It's way further out than Castro's against York. To me, it looks like Ruben might take it. Big chance for 2-1 here. It's a great position. We know Castro hit the bar as well, didn't he? It's Ruben. Oh, what a save from their keeper. That was heading top corner. Oh, what a save. We've kept it alive with Chickson. Put it in, but they've cleared it. What a chance.
As Jordan's just said, the two players have come in, and Jim O'Brien, almost identical to Castro's. Yeah, yeah. Bottom corner, we're 2-1 up.
More starts, that's it. Against no ball, we tried to cross it in all the time. Clearly not working. So, central, take some shots. There you go.
2-1 Knots, get in.
Smacker finally gets one.
Since that first goal, confidence has been sky high. It's a great shot, good save from the keeper, with his feet from O'Brien's effort. Match is there, 3-1. You hope that's game over, but you hope there's more goals for Knots at the same time. Been superb since the first. Catching up with Jake at half time. Some of the football in that half was unbelievable.
Okay.
Yeah, it was proper in that level.
They drew a poor goal to concede though first. That was awful, especially from our perspective. It looked terrible to concede. But you know, we've always looked positive. Flowing attack, whereas Castro's been actually really good. I think that's been really good.
Yeah,
it's really nice to see Jim get the goal. hectic, really. It was predominantly Jeff was bobbling.
Yeah, it almost feels like there's no, like Jim's never been away. Like his energy is
there. Slotted straight in. It's, you know, like you said, his energy and enthusiasm. It's just like he's never been away. So yeah, I really believe
that. That should be get the game done, shouldn't it?
Yeah, you know, I apart from that one opportunity they had, like they've cut us open a little bit. They've done nothing. They don't look ready. They're looking forward. So,
yeah, they do.
So it should be comfortable.
Yeah, we'll see what happens second half. Then 3-1 knots. This hasn't been as lively as the start of the first half, but not still on top. They had a very early chance. Had a ribbon to Jim, like 20 yards out, not scored. Yeah, they had an early chance, but we've bossed it against them. So we've got a corner. Yeah, they can't get out of their own half. Some of their pressure's been great. Ruben's been insanely good. Got a corner. Are we going to go long or are we going to go the usual short corner? Stick with you for this. Matty Palmer, Adebayor on edge of the box. Gives it back to Ruben. Dinks it in. Oh, keeper claims it, but we're just well on top. Corner to Knox. Austin on Castro off. We've taken it short. Works it well. And Scunthorpe do clear this. We're still really on top. And almost upset Scunthorpe have given up this. We've had a time, half an hour to go, but Ruben's picked it up about 25 yards out. Dinks a lovely ball. Cameron can't get much on it, and it looks as though Scunthorpe have cleared their lines, but we've kept it alive really nicely. Chixon flicks it past two. Scunthorpe do clear, but we are, you know, we're just toying with them now. Really good to see Jim back in. He's playing really, really well. His usual forward runs have been causing Scunthorpe problems all game, and Ed Francis replaces him. So really happy to see him back in, bolstering that midfield. Got really good depth in there now, and Ed comes on just to see this game out. I can't believe back at this. Ruben somehow keeps the ball alive. Mackie's got to tap it, he doesn't get enough on it. There's Scunthorpe clear it. We've got a corner. We've just sparked into life again. Adam Chixon wins us another corner. I can't believe we haven't scored there to make it four. Scott gets the goal, acrobatic finish, great work down the side, and that is really game over. Scunthorpe fans leaving. There we go. You can hear Notts fans, the games aren't over, Chesterfield and Wrexham aren't over, but as it stands right now, we're top. I'd love to see us get another. I'm hearing that York equalised against Wrexham. As I came off the last clip, York conceded an overhead kick to Wrexham. I mean, I'll probably re-record this because it's what Wrexham do, and they'll have scored another two, but I think York have equalised. So, I mean, I've no doubt Wrexham will probably win. But yeah, we're playing really well here. Game's over. We could have scored again. Yeah, I have no doubt Wrexham will probably score, so I'm not getting my hopes up. Have we had out of time yet?
No
out of time yet. Maybe 2 minutes. Who knows? Game's done and dusted. 4-1 win. York equalised somehow late on against Wrexham. They got their 7 minutes out of time. Obviously been using the World Cup system for out of time all season, but they couldn't get their goal in that one. So for now we're top of the league. I fully expect it to swap around 3 or 4 times again this season at least. One of us seems to win, the other seems to draw, and then we swap over. Benefit of coming to Scunthorpe, you've got M&S, you've got Tesco, you've got McDonald's, Subway. Have gone for a Subway after this with Jordan.
yeah, just get some food after the game. We're going to head back now. Jacob Drivers, not a lot of traffic on the road coming. Don't expect it on the way. Listen to the USA Netherlands game. But a very, very good win for Notts. Fans were really good today. Sell out. Players were just as good. Early scare, but, you know, we came away with a victory. Going to the next game. Maidenhead, if I'm right, away from home. Not the nicest place to go, but again, I'd expect us to get a victory. If you have enjoyed the video, please do leave a like, comment if you were at the game or if you listened along what you thought, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.